So, I mean, who controls skateboarding?
I don't think anyone really controls skateboarding.
I mean, I think the leaders in skateboarding, the pros, I think that they're leading the way.
Who runs skateboarding? What's going on, guys? It's Raul from the Crunkuts channel, and whether the Skate Informant sent you over here or you're already subscribed to me, regardless, thank you very much. Your time is highly appreciated. So this is by far my favorite question that has ever been asked. Who runs skateboarding? Well, according to a documentary that the Red Bull channel made in YouTube about this question, they asked several pros and the responses were just mixed. There wasn't a solid one. They asked Steve Barrow, for example, who partially runs the Barracks. They asked him who runs skateboarding and he says, nobody does. Nobody runs skateboarding. It's skateboarding. There's no rules to it. Then they asked Jamie Thomas, who also runs his own skateboarding company, and he says, well, the leaders in skateboarding, the top skaters run skateboarding because they have a huge impact on the consumer, on the people. So the question still remains, who runs skateboarding? Well, this thought triggered other thoughts, other questions in my head. For example, why is primitive skateboard so successful? Is it just the product alone what's causing the success? Or does Paul Rodriguez have a huge impact on this? Why does Grizzly Grip Tape have nearly three times as many followers on social media than Mob Grip does, even though Mob has been around for much longer? Is it the product alone, or does Tory Pudwell have something to do with this? And mind you, I know we're not talking about sales, we're talking about social media followers, but if you've ever been in retail, if you've been a business analyst of any sort, you know that marketing and sales are like this. It's almost the same thing. So, is it just the product, or is it the leaders in skateboarding? Who controls skateboarding? Well, there may not be a solid one answer to these questions, but one thing does remain unchanged, and it'll probably never change, and that's you guys. You as a consumer play a huge role in this because you are that factor that maintains these companies' function, standing, because without demand, there can't be any product for sale. These things are also super intertwined. So at the end of the day, if you ask me who runs skateboarding, my answer, it's you guys. You guys run skateboarding. So at the end of the day, as long as you buy whatever shoe fits your needs, as long as you buy whatever skateboard that has what you need, that pop, that concave, the shape, as long as it's a skateboarder operated and created brand, you're giving back to the community. You're putting this money back in skateboarding's pocket. So at the end of the day, you guys run skateboarding. That was just my peace of mind for this topic. If you're not subscribed to me just yet, go ahead and do so. If you want to see that documentary that I was talking about from Red Bull, I'm going to put the link in the description below. And I will see you guys next time. Reporting live from the Crunkuts channel, I'm Raul, and I'm out.